Hello everybody and welcome back to this channel. My name is Nauri Radwan and in today's tutorial I will be covering more tips and tricks. But before I do that, I have an announcement to make. Some of you have been asking me why I stopped doing the full-length artwork tutorials, and to be honest with you, I have no specific reason why I stopped doing them. However, I have been planning to do the full-length artwork tutorials live on our PM Photo Manipulation Discord server. So if you haven't joined yet, I will be leaving the link in the description down below. And without any further ado, let's start with this tutorial. This is going to be the artwork that I will demonstrate the techniques on. First, let me hide some objects and I will be back. I'm back after hiding the horse and the main subject. I know the tree looks weird in some parts. This is because it was covered by the horse and the object. But anyways, today I will show you how to add this little bushes right here to hide the bottom of the trunk of the trees or any object like I did with the subject and the horse. I will also show you how to add these trees right here to hide the bottom of buildings, castles, anything like that. And that's of course by using the tree filter that we covered in the last episode, but in today's tutorial I will show you more uses of that filter. So let's start first by adding these bushes, and I will also show you how to blend them together in the grass area. First, I will hide these ones that I already made. Next, what I will do is I will hide all the objects so you don't get confused. Now I will start explaining the technique. Let's start first by adding an empty layer. Then let's go to filter, render, and then click on tree. Now we have this bush right here and it's base tree type number 21. You will find this on this menu. This is the light direction and the other options values. You can copy these or you can just make your own. I will just click OK. I will add an empty layer once more, and then I will go to filter, and then let's click on render and tree. This time, make sure randomize shapes is checked so we don't have to go to the tree menu every time. Instead, we can just add an empty layer and click Ctrl Alt F. That will reapply the last filter that we applied, which is the tree one. And now I will separate them or change the location of every single tree and change the scale and make it random. Next, I will merge the three trees together by selecting them, then clicking on Ctrl E or Command E. I will convert that layer to smart object. Then I will click on Ctrl T. Then I will descale that object and put it right beneath the tree trunk to cover its bottom areas. I will just put it right there. Next, I will add another three trees. And what I will do with the new trees, I will convert them to a mask. And that's by going to layer menu, then go to layer mask. Then click from transparency. That will create a new mask from the transparent layer that we created from the trees. Now, I will hide this new tree layer. Then I will take the mask by clicking and holding Alt, then dragging it to the layer of the previous trees. I will remove the connection between the mask and the layer. Then I will click on the mask, then click and hold Ctrl or Command and I. And that's to invert the selection. And then I will click Ctrl T so I can move and scale the mask right here. You can see it right here. And then I will drag it just at the bottom of the bush that we created. As you can see, it's made a really good transition between the bush and the grass beneath it. I will drag the layer of the bush just like that. Next, I will blend the color of the bush with the rest of the grass. I will do that with a new technique that I discovered. It may work for you, it may not. I will add an empty layer, then I will clip it to the bush layer. Then I will sample a color from the mountain in the back, right here. And then I will paint on the empty layer so it fills all of the layer, as you can see. I will turn that layer to screen blending mode. Then I will decrease the opacity to 50%. I will add a curved adjustment layer, clip it to the bush layer, and make sure I put it above the painted layer right here. Then I will take this arrow right here to the right side to add contrast. Then I will take that point to the left side to add brightness just a bit. I will add a new hue and saturation adjustment layer, decrease the saturation just a bit, and then I will add color balance adjustment layer, set the blending mode to color. Then I will add red on the midtones and some yellow. On the shadows, I will add blue. On the highlights, I will add yellow and some green. Let's add more yellow on the midtones and some red. That should blend the color of the bush with the rest of the grass. Now I will show you how I did add this trees right here that covers the bottom of the castle. I will show you first the castle without these trees. This is the castle before I add the trees at the bottom, and this is it after I added the trees. Let me show you how I added these trees. Click on File, New, and make a new document. On the width, I will put 32 times 6. So it's 192 on both width and height. Let's create. And then let's remove that background and make sure everything is transparent. Or let's at least make the layer is transparent. Then let's go to Filter, Render, and then click on Tree. Let's add some trees in a random way or random shapes. Make sure you add more species. Also, make sure to change the options right here every now and then. After you make the trees, convert them to patterns. You can name them if you want. I will not because it's a tutorial. Next, using the pen tool, draw a line at the bottom of the castle or a building or whatever subject that you are working with. Click Control and then click on an empty area just to add a new line, just like that. After you add the lines, click and hold Shift F5. The Fill menu will show on your screen. On the Contents, select Patterns. On the Options, select Script, and make sure you click on Place Along Path. On the Custom Pattern, select the trees that you created as a pattern, and then click OK. The only two things that you want to change here is the pattern scale and the pattern spacing. Spacing at 0 pixels and the pattern scale at, let's say, 0.5, and let's click OK. That will add trees in that order. Let's add a new layer and let's click Shift F5 again and let's click OK. I will change the pattern scale and decrease it. With the spacing, I will select 18 maybe. Let's see how that turns. This is good. Maybe let's try and rotate it. As you can see, now it's not rotated anymore. It's not following the curve. To rotate it, it's connected to the direction of the shape of the pen tool. So if I click on that shape right here and I change the direction of it, going to like 45 degrees at the sky, and I will repeat the same process without skipping the symbol rotation, it will follow the direction of the shape of the pen tool, as you can see. Now, let's try and add another species of trees. Let's select the other one. And let's change the spacing. And let's skip the rotation. Let's go for that for now. Let's merge the two trees layers together. And then let's blend the color of it with the rest of the image. And that's by doing or repeating the same process again. Adding an empty layer, sample a color from the mountain in the back, paint on the empty layer that's clipped to the trees, change it to screen blending mode, increase the opacity to 50%, add a curves adjustment layer, clip it to it, and add contrast. And it looks like we don't have to do a lot of work right here. It's already blended. If you want, you can add a color balance adjustment layer and tweak some settings maybe, but for me it works great. One other thing that I want to cover is that the way I painted these shadows right here, this is after, this is before, this is after, and the way it's too simple. So as you can see, this is the layer of the castle, and this is the layer of the shadows. Here is how to do it. I will hide the shadows right now, and I will add an empty layer. Select a brush tool and paint with a black color on the areas that you want to add these shadows to. You don't have to be specific or professional, just paint like that on the areas that are not facing the source of the light. This is the areas that I want to add shadows to. Next, while clicking on that layer of the shadow, go to layer, layer mask, from transparency to add the mask. Then I will duplicate the layer of the castle by clicking on Ctrl J, flip it to the old layer of the castle, rasterize it if it's a smart object, drag it to the top, and let's add the mask of the painting that we did by clicking and holding Alt, then moving it to the layer of the new castle. Next step, click on Ctrl U, decrease the lightness, and to make sure that the shadow that you painted is not colliding with the other shadows or the original shadows on the original image, click 2 times on that layer to use the blend if. On the current layer option right here, take this slide or this arrow to the right side until it's one color. Start dragging it until it looks like it's one shade. So let's see, before, after. So this is how you add the shadows. I used the technique that I just covered to hide the bottom areas of that main character, also the horse, the shadows, the sheep, and also to cover the bottom areas of the castle. And I also used that technique of blending the colors of the bush with the grass to blend the rest of the scene together. I used it on the mountains. I used it on this land right here. I used it on the castle. I used it on all of the objects. So this is it for today's video. I hope you enjoyed this video. I hope you got value. If you did, show me that by clicking on the like button. Subscribe to the channel. And if you want to see more advanced tips and tricks like these, make sure to get my Digital Landscape Reloaded course. The link is going to be down in the description. Follow me on my social medias, join the Discord server, and I will see you in the next tutorial. Peace.